Hi students, today I am going to show how to do bubble sort algorithm. So far we discussed about bubble sorting means. Sorting means it is an arrangement of a list of elements in ascending order or descending order. That means you need to put the array elements in a ascending order or descending order. So bubble sort is the simplest algorithm which is used to sort given set of n elements provided in the form of an array with n number of elements. So that is the bubble sort. So in this I am showing bubble sort algorithm and implementation for how to implement the bubble sort. So bubble sort compares all the elements one by one and sort them based on their values. So that is depends upon values only. If the given array has to be sorted in ascending order, then the bubble sort will start by comparing the first element of the array with the second element. If the first element is greater than the second element, it will swap. Okay, swap the both elements. So and then move on to the compare second and third elements. Like that, so on until n minus 1 elements. If you have, for suppose if you have 9 elements, you need to compare at least 8 times. So that is the requirement. If we have n elements, then we need to repeat this process for n minus 1 times. So that is the requirement for a bubble sort. So if it is known as bubble sort, so why it is called bubble sort means because with every complete iteration, the largest element in the given array bubbles up towards the place of highest index. So index means what? Array is started from 0 to and ended up at n minus 1. So it is the first element, that is the biggest element, goes to highest index, that is n minus 1 place. So just like a water bubble rises of the water surface. So that's why it is called bubble sort. So sorting takes place by stepping through all the elements one by one like that, and comparing it with the adjacent element and swap them if required. If requires only, you will swap. Otherwise don't. So how to implement? So implementing bubble sort algorithm, so these steps are required. Here I am showing the algorithm. Step 1, start simply. Then step 2, declare required variables like list of some list array and indexing purpose I, j, k and some temp. These are the requirements for us. So here one more thing is required, that is nothing but n. So n is also required. So what is the need of n? So n is for to declare the size of the array. So read the size of array and array elements. So for suppose if I want my array length is 12, I can enter n value as 12, as well as I need to read 12 elements, my list. Next, this is the actual thing. So here I am showing with a different color. Starting with the first element index 0 and compare the current element with the next element of array. So 0th element compared to 1th element, 1th place element. So if the current element is greater than the next element of the array, swap them. Otherwise go to next element. If the current element is less than the next element, move to the next element. Repeat step 4. Once again you go to step 4 until completion of array. Next, after completion of sorting, just display sorted array. Simply display the array and stop the program. So here I am showing some example also, numerical example. Let us consider an array with values 5, 1, 6, 2, 4, 3. So I have total 6 elements. So here the steps involved in this thing. So 5 is greater than 1. 5 is first compared to 1. So interchange. No interchange. There is no swapping. So 5 is next, once again it is compared with 1. 5 is compared with 1, no change simply. So 6 is compared with 2. 6 is compared with here. Compulsory first step, what happening? 5 is compared with 1 and swapped. So in second step what happened? 5 is compared with 6, no change, because 5 is the smallest one. So next 6 is compared with 2, then compulsory there is a change. Then once again you need to do this 6 and 5. So like that every time you need to do step, interchanges. So interchange. So at the end you got, after all iterations you go to, so we can see that representation above after first iteration. So after first all iterations completed, you need to display your array. That is what implementation of bubble sort. Okay, so we will see now how to write the program. So what is my agenda? My agenda is nothing but to do bubble sort. To sort given array in ascending order. This is my intention. So now I want to start void main, then this is the skeleton program. So in this I want to develop first declaration section. What are the requirements for us? So I required array, so that is list. List of 100 elements I am declaring. So after that I required something, so int I, j, k and temp, as well as n also required. N is nothing but number of elements. This is required. So after this, just go to, so why I am writing this code means to read list of or length of array. So length of array printf, enter. How many you want to sort? So that is my question. The user is going to enter here scanf. Here we are reading the length of array that is stored in address of n. So now I am reading to read elements of array or elements of list. So the list of numbers I want to read. So printf, yeah, in a new line I am printing, enter the elements of array. This is what I am doing. Next here, for because repetition is required. How many times I need to repeat? N number of times I need to repeat. I is equal to 0, I less than n. So I plus plus. So because n value already we are reading, depends upon that value only it will take. So scan percentile d comma address of list of I. So depends upon index value, it will store corresponding elements in that. Reading completed. So here purposely I am printing what are my list, what is a given list, for that to print the list. There is nothing but given list. Here printf new line only I am printing given list. What is the given list for me? So once again repetition is required. So why I am writing always this thing means repetition purpose only, indexing purpose, because array stored in the form of successive memory locations. That's why we are always doing iteration I plus plus. So depends upon length it will repeat. So print, so print of the percentile d. So here comma is required because element to element separation. And list of I. So which index you take, that index only you need to print, because here I am taking I, that's why I am taking. Now I am doing bubble sort. Bubble sort. So here I am starting bubble sort. How to write the bubble sort? Here I am showing. So this is the actual code required for bubble sort. Now first what I want to compare, I want to repeat n number of times. K is equal to 0, k less than, so how many times I need to repeat? N number of times I need to repeat, k plus plus. So this repetition is required, so that's why here I am opening and here I am closing. So this loop is repeated n number of times. So for that purpose I am writing this loop. So here now first for every time, every element I want to compare, yes, in the list. So for that purpose I am writing for I is equal to 0, once again I plus, okay, I less than n minus 1. Why I am taking n minus 1 means I don't want to go out of the array. So for suppose next time in comparison the last element is compared with the outside of element, that's why if I value is repeated until n minus 1 only it is suitable. So for that purpose I am taking, logically I am doing that thing. So now, so this for loop is for up to, yeah, so this is the k thing. So here also I am closing for. Okay, so in for loop, this for loop, so outside also one for loop is there, that is repetition for n number of times. The inside loop is repeat for n minus 1 times. So now if the first element in the sense what, list of I, because I value is 0, is greater than list of I plus 1, that is nothing but the successive element, next element. So if this condition satisfies, then go into this thing and write in between only I need to write. So yeah, so this is first k1 is outside, these are nothing but, yeah, two loops opened here, two things are closed here. So inside I want to swap. What is the code for swapping? Temp is equal to, so list of I, and list of I is equal to list of I plus 1. If condition satisfies only, if the first element is bigger than second element only, you need to do this thing. Otherwise, just don't swap. Move to next element, next comparison. So temp is the list of I plus 1 is equal to temp. So this is called swapping. So after swapping, so this repeats until n minus 1 times every comparison is done. So after completion of one iteration I want to see what happened to my loop. So for that Here I am going to print once again, printf. After completion of one step, one complete comparisons, one set of comparisons, I want to see what happened to my array. That's why I called after first pass, after second pass, like that. After first step or after step 1. So how to get 1? I am taking the advantage here. After step 1, like that I am printing. So here k value, because k value is repeating n number of times, that's why I will print k only. So why I am taking plus 1 means, so I don't require it after step 0, after step 1, like that. It is not started from 0. So k value is started from 0, that's why I am taking k plus 1 means it is started from 1, after step 1, after step 2, like that. So just for j is equal to 0, j less than n, and j plus plus. This is simple printing purpose I am using. So print so percentage d, same logic. So everywhere it is same logic. Next list of j, because I am using index as j, so I need to use j only. So done, printing completed. So this is for sorting. So simply the bubble sorting algorithm is like this only. This is only, so what you saw on the screen from bubble sort to here. So after every step I am observing the output. So after completion of the thing, printf. So what is the thing, actual thing? So after sorted list I want to see. So printf / n sorted list. Sorted list. So this is what I want to observe. For I is equal to 0, just simply printing once again. I less than n I plus plus. So next printed percentage d comma just list of I. Okay, complete. So this is my code. Now I want to execute the Alt FS. So bubble sort. Okay. Alt F9. 0 error, 0 warnings. Then one error is there. So what is that? So undefined symbol scan. Yeah, instead of writing something I wrote, that is Alt F9. Okay. Where is that? Scan. Yeah. Scan. Alt F9, control. Enter how many elements you want to sort. For suppose I want to sort 8 elements. So what are the elements? So I am entering my elements 8, 3, 28, minus 90, 46, 7, 2, 9, like this. So here it is printing like this because of after each step I didn't give any space. So that's why I am not giving new line. That's why it is printing like this. So I want to see that thing once again. Here given list is printed commonly. So here n is missing, that's why. So / n. Okay, now see. So some elements, 10 elements I am giving. So 6, 7, 3, 1, minus 90, 8, 2, 4, minus 120. So like this you have plot. Okay, see, this is after each step what happened. So minus 90, minus 120 is the first element after sorted list. I am observing after sorted list what happened. So first the largest element is 8 only in this. So first iteration only, after first step 8 is go to last position. In second step 7 is go to last step. So like that 120 is moving everywhere. So moving down up to 0. So after 9 steps only, 8 steps only you got answer. See, after 8 steps only you got answer. But the algorithm is doing regularly, how many times you repeated that many times it will do. So unnecessarily it is doing 2 extra steps, but we will see later how to stop at exact time, that is called optimization, we will do later. So this is how to implement bubble sort algorithm. Thank you. And don't by heart the program, understand. Okay, thank you.